Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit Probit regression models with categorical predictors. I'm also going to show you how to test hypotheses after you fit the model, estimate marginal predictions, as well as create some plots. I'm going to be using the NLSW88 dataset, and you can download this by typing webuse NLSW88. And I've described the two variables that we'll be using for this model. Union is an indicator variable for union membership, and that's going to be our binary dependent variable. And industry is our categorical predictor variable. Notice that there is a value label attached to industry, and so I've typed label list, INDLBL, and that shows me the various categories of industry. So one refers to ag, forestry, fisheries, two refers to mining, and so forth. So let's begin by going to statistics, and I'm going to select binary outcomes. And then I'm going to select Probit regression. So here in the dialog box, I'm going to select my binary dependent variable, which is union. I can find it here, union. And then for my independent variables, I'm going to click this little three-dot box here. And I'm going to leave factor variable selected, and the specification is main effect. And here I'm going to select industry. So if I select industry, industry is a categorical variable, so I don't need to check this box underneath C dot. That tells Stata that this is a continuous predictor, and it's not, so I'm going to leave it unchecked. And I'm not going to be using any time series operators or mess with the base category. So after I do that, I can click Add to Var List, and then I'm going to click OK, and notice that industry has been added to my list of independent variables here. So I'm going to click OK, and we'll come back and talk about that I dot here in a moment. So the dialog box created the command probit, followed by our binary dependent variable union, and then we also have our predictor, our categorical predictor industry. And notice that the dialog box added an I dot in front of industry. That tells Stata that industry is a categorical predictor, and it creates indicator variables for each category for us. There are a couple of notes here. We're going to ignore those for now. It's just some things where certain categories predict failure perfectly and things like that. So if I scroll down and look at the output, I see the number of observations at the top, a likelihood ratio chi-square and its p-value along with a pseudo r-squared. And then I see a coefficient for each category of industry. So unless you're good at thinking on a probit scale, these coefficients can be challenging to interpret, and we'll come back to that in a moment. We might also want to test the null hypothesis that all of these coefficients are simultaneously equal to zero. If I look down the list of p-values, some categories have small p-values and other categories have larger p-values. And I might want to test that all of these are simultaneously equal to zero. So I can do that by going to the command window here and typing test parm I dot industry. And that will test that all of those coefficients are simultaneously equal to zero. So I get an omnibus chi-square test here along with its p-value. So again, these coefficients can be challenging to interpret because they're on a probit scale. So let me show you how to estimate marginal predictions from that model. I'm going to go to statistics and scroll almost all the way down to where it says post-estimation. And this opens Stata's post-estimation selector. This allows you to do all kinds of things after you fit any regression model. You can do goodness of fit analyses, predictions, tests, contrast, and things like that. I'm going to expand, click plus to expand this menu for marginal effects, estimated means, and interactions. And I'm just going to do some basic things here. I'm going to select basic and low dimensional analysis and click launch, and this will open the margins dialog box. Here at the top of the main tab, I'm going to select the type of covariate as categorical. I could do a continuous covariate, but I don't have any continuous covariates in this model. The covariate in the model is industry, and Stata knows that. And then for the analysis type, I'm going to select marginal means of outcome for levels of covariate. There are other things we can do, elasticities and contrasts and other things, but let's keep it simple. So that's all I need to do, and I'm going to click OK. And this will, let me move this over so we can take a look at the output here. If I scroll back up, the dialog box issued the command margins followed by industry. And if I look at the output, what Stata has done is estimated the marginal predicted probability of union membership for each category of industry. So for ag, forestry, and fisheries here, the predicted probability of being a member of a union is about 0.167 if I were to round that. For someone in the entertainment industry, the predicted probability is about 0.14 rounded. And for each of those predicted probabilities, I get a standard error, a z-test, and a p-value, as well as a 95% confidence interval. So a handy way to view these is to create a profile plot. So I'm going to come back to the post-estimation selector and select Profile Plots after Marginal Analysis and click Launch. So this opens the Margins Plot dialog box. And in the main tab, I'm going to specify industry for the variable that defines the x-axis. So let's click Submit and see what this does. So this creates something called a profile plot. On the horizontal axis, we see a list of, we see each category of industry, and it's difficult to read those because the titles kind of overlap on top of each other. And we'll come back to that in a moment. The vertical axis is the predicted probability of being a member of a union. And then for each category of industry, we see a dot that displays the predicted probability of union membership, and it's surrounded by a 95% confidence interval. Each of those predictions is connected by a line, and so that's why this is a profile plot. Now, the horizontal axis here is a little tricky to read, so one way to get around this to make it easier to read is simply to come back to the dialog box and check this box next to swap the x and y axes. So if I click Submit, that's going to transpose the graph, and so it makes it easier to read these longer labels for each category of industry. And that changes the horizontal axis to the predicted probability of union membership. So some people prefer to see these as a bar chart. So if I come back to the dialog box and click on the plot tab here, I can change the plot type to bar. So I'm going to select bar and click submit. So now it displays a bar for each category. Bar charts usually have gaps between them. So if I click bar properties over here for bar width, I could change that to maybe 0.9. And when I submit that, now I see a little gap in between each bar. If I wanted to, I could even change this to a scatter plot. So if I go back to the plot tab here, I could select scatter and change that to a scatter plot. One thing that I like to do sometimes with these scatter plots is add a little space at the top and bottom. And so if I come back to the dialog box, I can click the overall tab and then click region properties. And then click the plot region tab, and at the very top it allows me to add a margin. So I'm going to try medium at first and see what happens. So let's click medium. That added a little space. Let's see what happens if we change that to large. Click submit. That might be a little bit too much, so medium might look a little better there. Okay, and so that is how we can create some margins plots. So let me show you one last trick here. I'm going to close all these dialog boxes and go back over here to the history window. And I'm just going to select any command here in the history window. I'm going to right click on it and select all. And then I'm going to right click again and I'm going to select send selected to do file editor. And that sends all of those commands that were generated by the dialog box to the do file editor. And I can save this file and I can rerun my entire analysis over and over again if I want to. It also allows me to view all of these various options that were created by the dialog box to customize my plot. So this is a handy learning tool as well. So that's how you can fit Probit regression models with a categorical predictor variable, test some hypotheses, estimate some marginal predictions, and create some graphs from your model. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.